the Hunger Games are pretty creative makeup-wise, and I really wanted to work with Trish, the costume designer, and Frances. So once I talked to Trish and kind of got her insight on what the film was going to be, I was really excited. And it definitely opened up possibilities. And Frances talked to us early on about, you know, the look of the film, and he wanted it to be really gritty and dark and dirty. And then there's just so many different types of characters on this film too, that we were doing period with a twist, and we were doing, you know, people that have been in a truck in mud for, you know, we'd be living in that world for a week and then switch over to like the academy and the lakeside. And so there were so many different avenues that we could really be creative on this film. Lucy, she has quite a few looks on this, weirdly enough. And we started with the games, so we had a lot of, you know, it was just her dirty and sweaty the whole time. And then, you know, once we moved on to the lake scenes and stuff like that, we got to take that down and do a little more natural look. Once we got to the lake, we did a little more natural look and less dirt and a youthful look. But we also got to do some really fun looks for the Hob. She had two different performance looks, and then the Reaping Day too. Most of the people in District 12 were always really dirty and covered in coal, and so, except for on the Reaping Day, it was as if they cleaned themselves up. And for me, I looked at Lucy like that was almost a performance. She knew what she was doing. So I gave her more of a look that day. The funny thing about that is, since we started with the games, I had to do that look on her first off camera and take it back to what it would have worn down to during the games. So that was interesting to do it that way. But then the Hob also, her two performance looks were quite fun to do. The thing about makeup in District 12, and I talked to Frances about this, you know, they don't really have anything. So everything she would put on herself had to come from somewhere. So I would create backstories for how did this get here and why would this color be on her? So we had, like, you know, rosy lips and cheeks were from raspberries, and then one of the Hob scenes, she had a really like iridescent bluish green eyeshadow that we said she crushed up beetles and put those on her eyes. Like, every, it became kind of a game with us, like, where did this come from? So that was fun. Coal with the for eyeliner or mascara. So we kind of started playing that game with Lucy, which was fun. Trish, you know, has such an amazing eye and is so creative, and everything she does, I'm just blown away by. And it's really inspiring when I see her illustrations and things. It just immediately brings out the creativity in myself. And she's very collaborative. Like, everything I do, I run through Trish first, before even Frances, because she has a vision, and then I see her illustrations and I try to match her vision. And she's just really an amazing costume designer, and it's really made me so thankful to work with her. Yorn, again, it started with the aging makeup, and so he created all of that and got that approved. And then we had found out that Viola wanted to have two different color eyes for this. So one of her contacts is an ice blue that I created with Jessica Nelson in Los Angeles. And Sergio, who is Viola's makeup artist, created the eye shape and the lip on her, and I think he obviously that was amazing. So the whole look together and the hair, all of that together was so so amazing, and it just like brought that character to life so much. And you know, then you throw the costume and her acting, and it's just a really magnetic character. So yeah, it was, that one's pretty fun.